this weekend's ABT tour stop. As you may or may not know, I mentioned it in a past video that I was going to be doing, or at least bowling an ABT tour in March. And it just happens to be this one, mostly because it's close to my house and gas, as you may or may not know, has skyrocketed. Well, I don't want to get into that. But the ABT stop is going to be at AMF North Glen Lanes this weekend, March 26th and 27th. Yeah, that sounds right. I don't have a calendar on me. It's been a long day. But I thought I would come down and give a little practice session before I actually bowl the qualifying on Saturday. I was hoping that I could get them to lay out the pattern for me, but unfortunately no can do. So I'm gonna be going into this thing blind. They did release the pattern. It is the it's the 2022 US Open pattern. So you can go ahead and Google that and see what fresh hell I've gotten myself into. It's a short pattern, 36 feet. So yeah, out of the frying pan right into the damn fire, huh? There's no easing into this. First tournament right out of the box is going to be a pro pattern that I've never bowled on before, so I will be going into this blind, like I said. So, but I don't want to focus on that too much. That's triggering me, and I don't want to get down. I'm like super excited, super nervous about doing this on Saturday. So, I'm out here to practice, and I am going to make it a worthwhile practice. You know, focus on the things that you can control, and the things that you can't, you know, it's whatever. But if you focus on what you can control, then, you know, should be okay. And what I can control, even though I haven't bowled on the 2022 US Open Championship pattern before, one variable I can control is making my spares. I can control my body movements. I can make sure my swing is online. I can make sure that I'm releasing the ball correctly. So this is going to be a real practice session. We are going to do drills. We are going to do one and four-step approach. I saw Shannon O'Keefe do a couple days ago on YouTube. Well, not four-step approach, but a swing training. It's four steps. You'll see it. It's really cool. I'm interested to try it, but we're going to do swing training. We're going to do timing. We're going to do release drills, all of that. We're going to do some spare pickups, corner pin practice. So like I said, we're gonna work on the things that we can work on and try and control what we can control. And, you know, we'll just have to wait and see. We'll go into this Saturday, you know, feeling confident that we can execute and play our game. That's what you want to do. So, get started. Here, of course, just gonna have the spare ball out. Good old bad intentions. And to start off with, I think I'm going to do some release drills. I'm going to start off doing my favorite release drill, of course, the foul line release drill, where you're in ready position, where you're in your finish position, and you just swing the ball, and it helps loosen up the shoulders, helps keep your swing online. So to the foul line, and I am trying, in this instance, I'm going to try and hit some arrows. I am going to try and shape the shot a little bit, but as we do, get into finish position, make sure my shoulders are square, make sure my back is upright and flat, and just let the ball come up and just come through. Now, I am going to attempt my spare doing the same thing, but as I come up with the ball on my backswing, I'm going to flatten my wrist out to flatten the ball out and take some of the hook off of it. Ah. But you see the difference in the roll. That ball was a lot flatter. I did miss my mark. But like I said, we're not focusing on that right now. We're getting the shoulder loose and warmed up. I'm making sure our hand feels good at the bottom of the release. Okay, so just for reference, if you care, I know it's a little far away, but I am standing on 25, actually in between 25 and 30, my left foot. Okay. For reference, this probably would be a strike ball. All right. Into finish position. Chest out. I'm truly just trying to get the ball to just kind of release off my fingers. I probably should have stretched before I did started. Want to make sure you stretch. Well, bowling is legitimate as any other sport. You want to make sure your body is in good condition. You don't want to get a cramp while you're bowling, because that would suck. All right. There we go. Now that felt a little better. See, I'm able to get it. It's starting to roll off my fingers more, which is exactly the motion that you want. We're gonna zoom in here. See if you can't get a shot of see if you can't get a shot of my hand at release. I doubt it, but we'll see. Ugh, there. All right, that seems like something. Actually, you know what? Let's do this. Cool, perfect. Go ahead and set that back up. I don't know how good or bad that shot actually was. We'll see when I look at it. Obviously, you don't have the time to do this during practice for a tournament or league, but you do, you know, at the beginning, you do want to do something to get yourself warmed up, make sure your swing is online. See, that had a lot of fingers in it. That one had a lot of fingers in it. I think I'm gonna do a couple more foul line release drills, and we're gonna move to that one-step approach. Okay, I'm gonna hold the ball at my side. Just swing a couple times and then release. It's also a very good target release drill. I think I'm gonna actually come back to that one a little later on. Work on some target practice for my strike ball. All right. Feeling pretty good, feeling pretty warmed up. Feel like my release is where it should be. So we are actually gonna do one more. We're at the fifth frame. We're gonna do one more. Now, what is the importance and the point of all of this, you might ask? The whole point of practice and drills is muscle memory. you want your muscles to get in the habit of doing the same thing over and over again. That's why muscle memory is so important. That's why practice is so important. And that's why it's so important that you practice something worthwhile when you practice, so that you train and develop your muscles to get that muscle memory. I often like to tell people during the summer, well, the fall actually, that I came back into the sport. I basically took that entire fall, or the end of the fall, the end of the year. I took the end of 2019-ish, and that whole summer tore down and rebuilt my backswing entirely, and it improved my game immensely. But I had to do that, and it took that long just to develop that muscle memory. So eventually your body gets to a point to where it's natural and you're not even thinking about it. I'm going to do the same thing on this one. I'm going to try and pick it up. I'm going to flatten my hand out. I'm going to aim for the center arrow. Well, that wasn't it. Execute good shots, kids. All right. Shoulders loose, we're going to move on to the one-step approach. We like to use that when we did our swing in motion with our feet now. So, as you know, if you've seen me do this before, you're going to stand about 2 feet from foul line. In your approach position, swing the ball and slide forward. And the whole goal of this exercise is to get your body in line, and so you make sure you feel comfortable in your slide and finish position, basically the last motions of your bowling ball approach and release. Actually, stand on this side. We're going to do the same thing. So about 2 feet back. I'm going to square my shoulders, find my target. Swing, slide, and release. And actually, I'm going to stand a little bit further back from the foul line. It doesn't feel natural. Feels stopped. Remember, you want your slide, you want to be able, it's natural, so how you would normally bowl. In doing that, I feel so much more, I feel more comfortable, my body feels natural. And my shoulders snap into that position at the release. Still tell them I'm forcing the ball a lot. There was a lot of arm in that. I'm not letting my backswing come up to the top and rest and start that natural slide. Also, I want to work on getting my arm straight on the push off, and that straightness will allow the ball to drop and just create that pendulum effect. So these are the things that we're trying to work on and accomplish with our drills and our practice. All right. So we're gonna concentrate on letting our swing come to the top, rest, and apex. There we go. That felt really good. And just to kind of recap that motion, this is the last motion before you go into the slide and release, and that's where you really want to be in tune. Drills, drills, drills. Had to check the mic. Oh my God, wouldn't it have been terrible if the mic wasn't on this whole time? All right. Okay. That felt good. Really working on pushing that ball out, getting that elbow extended and letting it come down. The thing that I want to stress the most in swing training, in timing training, but mostly in swing training and getting your arm trained, is to let the ball swing your arm, not the other way around. You want to let the ball swing your arm, meaning you want to let the ball get to those natural resting points. So when you're up there and you're at your approaching of your push-off, you want to get your arm out. That getting it out will naturally cause the ball to drop and go into that pendulum motion. Then you just want to let it swing up, come to its resting point, and then when it starts to drop, that's when you put your wrist on it, whatever, what have you. But you want to make sure your arm is relaxed. You want to make sure that the ball is swinging your arm, because when you start to arm it, when you start to put too much on it, that causes bad shots. They're not natural shots. So those are the things that I'm trying to work on. That was good. That was a good drill sesh. I think now we're going to, I'm still working on timing drills. I'm still working on timing and swing drills. So what I think I'm going to do is try that four-step drill that I saw Shannon O'Keefe do. And so with this drill, essentially you just start swinging the ball. You walk, and it's to help you, your swing, get in line with your steps. Never done this before. I might fall on my ass. Who knows? Okay, that's weird. So I might not be able to do this one, as it's for a four step, and I don't have a four step. I have a five step. Let's see. That was kind of awkward. Let's see. Yeah, that's kind of awkward. I might not be able to do that with a five-step approach. But what I can do is a one-step approach. I feel like I need to do more swing training. I'm not quite ready to move on from that yet. Nope. Nope, nope, the ball just dropped. Okay. I don't know what that was. That was bad. It was poorly executed. All right, Chuggy's gonna move on. What I think we're gonna do now, we're gonna do a full approach. Ball's not supposed to bounce. There was a lot wrong with that. See that number? 17.27, that's bad. That's a bad number. Shouldn't be cranking it down the lane that fast. All right, slow down. Just remember. I'm actually generating too much power. I need to slow it down. Some spares practice after this, and I want to work on my stance at approach, working on keeping my back straight, my shoulder down. That was about the most solid shot I've thrown. So many things going into practicing. Whoops. So we need to work on my stance. I'm trying not to be slumped over too much like that. I'm trying to work on keeping my back straight, but my right shoulder low. Which forces my shoulders to be pointed, almost like I'm cradling a baby. Feet feel off. Yeah, Yeah, I guess what we're working on next game.
Corner pins!
Straight, shoulder down, and I need to keep the ball about chest height. That's another issue I'm having. There we go. Yes. I know what you're thinking, but you missed. In fact, it went around the 8-pin entirely. Don't care. Not the point. Point is, that ball looked good, felt good off my fingers. I missed my mark, but that had the tilt, that had the rotation, that had the speed that I was looking for. So, yeah, lots to practice on. I see, the more I roll, the more I see wrong with my game that I want to change. Obviously, I'm not going to fix this all by Saturday, but, you know, working out the kinks. It's bowling. Whoops, hold on. There we go. You can see my beautiful face. There we go.
Oh, wow. Did you think we were done? Oh, no, heifers.
Nope, we're just getting started now. Now that I'm sufficiently warmed up and my swing is where it should be, we're going to work on some corner pins. We're going to work on some corner pin practice. Everybody's favorite. So, what is that going to entail? Well, hitting corner pins is all about hitting your market, getting the ball to roll, market, hitting your mark, and getting the ball into a roll, and, you know, just basically going straight at it. So that's what we're going to work on. We're going to work on flattening out our wrist and just executing good shots. So your corner pins, generally as a rule of thumb for corner pins and anything else, you want to be opposite side of the pin you're aiming for. So for this ball, I'm going to be aiming for the 10 pin. I'm going to be on the opposite side, way past 30. I'm on about, I don't know, 40 something. I'm on like 39. All right. That was bad. I missed my mark. I didn't flatten my wrist. Still, this time I'm going to aim for the 7. Even though there's not a 7 there. There we go. It's that whole motion, that movement. We want to just come out of the ball slowly, just put it down and let it roll. And now try it again. That was still a little errant. First, I mean, okay, I guess I'm gonna admit, I don't really know where I'm aiming. I'm probably over way too far to the left. There we go. We're gonna bring it in. Point our toes. Actually, we're gonna aim for in between the middle. So the thing that I'm struggling with, as you can tell, I can't create angle on that 10 pin. Normally I can hit that shot all day long. You know, I guess I can put a little bit of English, as they say in billiards, put a little bit of spin on it to keep it online, to keep it from washing out into the gutter after it leaves the oil pattern. Okay, we're gonna bring our mark in. We're gonna aim in between 15 and 20. Nope. Ah. Figure something out. Flatten that wrist out.